Good afternoon, and welcome to the 51st West Burlington Arnold High School graduation ceremony. It is a pleasure to have family, friends, members of the faculty, members of the school board, and of course, the honored graduates present to share in this important day. On behalf of the West Burlington faculty, I'd like to congratulate the graduating class of 2014. It is a significant milestone and very exciting day for you, your families, and your friends. As you leave West Burlington, take this challenge to be so strong that nothing can disturb your peace of mind, to make all your friends feel that there is something in them, to look at the sunny side of everything, to give so much of yourself to the improvement that there is no time to criticize others, to think of only the best, to work only for the best, and to expect the best. I say these words to you because there's only one person that can stop you, and that's you. Have the courage to follow your heart and your intuition. Graduates of 2014, today is the end of one journey and the beginning of another. So take this time to stand up for your dreams, work every day to make them a reality, and I wish the class of 2014 the very best luck in everything they do and all their endeavors. Promise graduates that's the last sermon from the Snodgrass, so you'll be fine. All right, Kicking off today's ceremony, we have a special vocal presentation that is a combined effort from the seniors that are graduating and the West Burlington Arnold High School Concert Choir. Under the direction of Miss Alice Cook, the seniors and the concert choir will perform Wake Me Up. Thank you, Mrs. Cook, seniors, and the concert choir. The class of 2014 have selected two of their classmates to deliver the customary senior address. A special multimedia tribute to honor the class of 2014 will immediately follow the senior address. Please join me in welcoming two outstanding representatives to the class of 2014, Ms. Kaylee Doctorman and Mr. Connor Tillo.
Ladies and gentlemen, I can't wait to get started. But first, let me take a selfie.
Fellow graduates,
faculty, staff,
parents, relatives,
immature underclassmen, and anyone else we've missed.
Good afternoon, and welcome to the graduation ceremony for the West Burlington's class of 2014.
You know, Kaylee and I are honored that our class chose us to speak to you today. And let me tell you this, you're in for a fun 8 minutes.
You know, most of the time these speeches are just made up of song lyrics like, "Don't stop believing" and "Let's get this party started."
But this speech is gonna be a little different, maybe a little unorthodox.
So, let's get this party started.
We've decided to do one thing that most people are afraid to do, and that's give it to you straight.
We're up here today just to talk about our history, our life, and we ain't gonna sugarcoat it.
Ain't gonna do that.
And we probably shouldn't say ain't when we're trying to celebrate our education.
That's just the way we play at homes, you know. Life out there, it's gonna be tough. But we can't go to our bosses anymore with a note from our mothers, so.
It ain't that easy.
Well, strong words, I know. Tough love, but, you know, this is the real world.
And this is where hard work is important. West Burlington, class of 2014.
We are what some have called the greatest in our school's history. Not many, just some. Actually, so far, just me.
Our time at West Burlington, what can I say? Make no mistake, West Burlington is one of the finest in the land, and we graduates are that fine as well.
We are young men and women whose exuberance exudes a confident confidence of a bygone era. I believe it was Shakespeare who said it best when he said, "Look yonder into the darkness, for knowledge which unto I give to you, which thou possess into thy night. For thee have come with only a single sword and vanquished thee into darkness." I'm going to be honest with you, I just made that up.
So we walk through the doors of elementary school, lunchboxes stuffed with Lunchables and juice boxes, nervous yet very eager to begin something that would last for 13 long years. As we progress through middle school, drama immersed our class, circles of the jocks, nerds, band geeks, tech guys were formed, and we spread rumors and stabbed each other in the backs.
Or as I like to call it, Congress.
High school came next, but as we had already spent the last few years dealing with drama, we didn't really care. The past 4 years have gone by fast, like dust in the wind.
Now here we are, haven't accomplished much, managing to scramble by at the last second, like usual. In fact, even Kevin Chang, and I got his permission to use his story, he was procrastinating for a composition class, an hour before the deadline, fingers typing madly away until he was diagnosed with carpal tunnel syndrome.
Instead of the cheesy quote for the class that you can find on the program, Miss Reed should have just said one word.
Procrastination.
I'd like to change gears here if I could and talk about the people and things that meant the most to us during our stint at school.
I want to thank Google, Wikipedia, and whoever invented copy and paste.
Shout out to the sidewalks for keeping me off the street.
I also want to thank Mr. Adams for laughing at us evilly over his podium whenever we ask a simple question.
Oh, how we will miss his bluegrass music.
Mrs. Reed, I want to thank you for your thousands of textual cues. Riding in style, black Cadillac wheels.
And her constant quoting, students, say it with us, to waste
your
time
is to waste your life. The constant yelling from Mr. Gurius to squat lower.
And from Yowie to get a pass.
And Mr. Rode, how I'll love hearing your voice in early winter mornings.
If it were up to me, you'd get a raise, a very handsome raise indeed.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Mike Moffitt is in the house. Where are you, Mike? Oh, he's not here? He's not here? He's probably warm in the hall. I also want to thank Mr. Blinn for bringing us together now. I'll wait.
And folks, gracias to Senora Bates for reminding me that I can never visit Mexico, ever. And I'd love to say something funny about Ms. Chanel, but for those of you who don't really know her and don't get the pleasure to know her, there's too many funny stories to tell.
Mr. Snodgrass, our principal is here. Always the life of the party, and just an all-around good guy. He previously told me that the school is circled with a team of 130 highly trained snipers, so that's all I have to say about Mr. Snodgrass.
Mr. Reed, I just have one thing. I will never, never roller skate in a buffalo herd.
All right, well, enough joking around. On a serious note, we do want to thank our high school teachers for preparing us for our futures, but we also want to prepare our elementary teachers, too. They don't get enough credit.
We wouldn't be here if it weren't for Mr. Magel, Miss Nelson, Miss Hempel, Miss Chris Reed, Miss Elliott, Mr. Prickett, Miss Kiki and Vetter, Miss Sherwood, and the many other countless people who shaped us to who we are today.
Mm-hmm. And a last thank you to our parents, for we wouldn't be here without them, literally.
Our future, what does it hold? For many of us, it'll be 4 years of college and 10 years paying for books that were $500 each.
Many of us will later become captains of the economy, leaders of the industry, and business owners.
Others will go on to great careers in medicine, science, and the military.
Two of us, and I'm not at liberty to say which two, will go on to careers in fields that I'm not allowed to talk about in public. I don't know why it's funny. It's a serious statistic, all right? I'm talking about politics, of course.
Jeez, get your mind out of the gutter, people.
All right, here's your warning. We're now entering the part of the speech that's supposed to be meaningful. So those of you who have enough meaning in their lives can go do something else, like try to remember where they parked the car.
Follow your dreams, stay true to yourself, and never follow someone else's path. Unless you're in the woods and you're lost, you should probably follow that path if you see one.
Wait a minute. You know, scratch that part about talking about dreams, following your dreams, because what if they're stupid dreams? If we all would have followed our first dreams, the world would be overrun with cowboys and princesses. So, talking about dreams, here's another piece of advice. Go after your own dreams, not someone else's, all right? Do what you want to do. For example, if everyone had my dream and went after my dream, there would be 7 billion politicians in this world. And let me tell you, nothing would get done. So, move on to new dreams, something bigger and better perhaps, and follow your own heart.
Don't be afraid to question your leaders, but don't ask too many questions at one time or that are too hard.
Never give up on something you can't go a day without thinking about.
And remember that there will always be someone there for you.
Colossians 3:23 says, "Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart as if working for the Lord."
Because after today, nothing will ever be the same.
Going to Chinese on Tuesdays, messing around in the school library, hanging around in my office, that's all gone.
The day-to-day routine that we've grown accustomed to for the past 13 years is over.
But with endings come beginnings, so it's time to flip to the next page in our life, in our next chapter, in our story.
We sincerely hope that you all have enjoyed the chapter in your long, adventure-filled lives, but because it'll be great.
So, don't stop believing.
Let's get this party started.
Thank you. God bless.
Welcome to Falcon Focus with your hosts, Springer DeRozier and Alexis Hawley. Sports with Brandel Diaz and Tyson Abbott. Dayton Elliott and Heidi Brown reporting live. And West Burlington's number one skit team. Here's Springer and Alexis.
Welcome back to our final Falcon Focus.
It's that time where we come to celebrate the past 13 years together.
Graduation! Thank you for sticking around with our shenanigans this year and the past few years of Falcon Focus.
We want to dedicate this episode to our class, this year's graduating class of 2014. Guys, we did it.
my co-host said, it's graduation, which also means it's baseball and softball time, which brings us to Falcon Sports.
Thanks, Springer. Me and Tyson want to wish a congratulations to all the spring sports this season.
A special shout out to the Falcons and Nikes that are conference champions. These champions include the girls and the boys track team.
Well, the formalities are done. Let's get to it.
With baseball and softball seasons beginning, the Falcons will take their first home stance against Van Buren on the 27th.
Come out and show your Falcon spirit.
As this is the graduation episode, we want to mention the seniors this year.
The boys' athletes this year are Christian Ramos, Brandon Paduano, Sheldon Brockett, Gerard Lewis, Springer DeRozier, A.J. Lee, Kyle Rokas, Logan Reich, Tanner Stainbrook, Augusto Quieres, Kevin Chang, and Connor Tillo.
The girl athletes are number 1, Alexis Cawley, number 72, Jaslyn Boyd, number 2, Mackenzie Larpender, Dayton Elliott, Kaylee Doctorman, Darian Ringgold, Jalen Brissy, and my best friend, Boo Thang, Ride or Die, and my bae, Brandel Diaz.
Thank you, Dyson. Well, this is all for my last Falcon Sports.
I'm gonna miss you, Brandel.
There, Tyson. Well, goodbye, West Burlington. Falcon Pride. Falcon Pride.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for us to look back. Lawmaker in Des Moines has introduced legislation that would help slow the exploding coyote population by paying hunters a stipend for each coyote they kill, said the lawmaker who introduced the bill. Meet me.
Bill Clinton revealed that he now supports same-sex marriage, even though he opposed it during his presidency. To be fair, during his presidency, he also opposed his own marriage.
President Obama took his Joint Chiefs of Staff out to a steak restaurant in honor of Victory in Europe Day. This marked the first time in years that the words Obama and well done appeared in the same sentence.
Vice President Joe Biden revealed that he uses Men's Clinique to keep his skin smooth, while John Boehner revealed he uses Bearwood Stain, like this.
After this break, we have Heidi and Dayton interviewing our senior class about graduation.
Okay, Joel, what are your plans after high school?
I'm going to be going to SEC for the Network Administration and Cybersecurity Program.
Wow!
SEC for 2 years, and then transfer Idaho State for the veterinary program.
Well, after high school, I would like to attend the University of West Burlington, the greatest college on the planet of the Earth.
Western Illinois University. I'm going to go to SEC.
I'm gonna keep playing music and probably involved in SEC. I'm going to Iowa State.
To
be an engineer.
Marry this guy.
I'm going to Iowa State University.
You doing an open major?
Yes.
That's what I'm doing.
Yes.
Okay, and what is your advice for the underclassmen?
Don't do anything stupid. Yeah, that's about it.
Have fun.
Don't grind at school dances.
Well, I have some great advice for the underclassmen. It consists of growing up.
Good one.
That's awesome.
Kevin. Don't take any college classes.
Actually, do your work. Don't waste your time. You'll be mine.
Stay in school.
To not be serious in high school because it's not
have
the most important
fun.
Thing.
That's right.
Woo! Popularity doesn't matter.
I like that.
Oh yeah, I want to say goodbye. I'm one of the Falcon Focus members. I'm definitely going to miss it. And if you guys ever want to look at some of the old videos, just look on YouTube or our Facebook page.
And now to get some advice, here is West Burlington staff and faculty in a segment called Life Quotes from Your Teachers.
today, boys and girls, I would like to tell you about my favorite quote. It's one that my old dear mother used to tell me when I was down on life. And what she told me is, nobody, nobody can get ahead of you as long as they're kicking you in the seat of your pants.
Without sunshine is like, you know, night.
Just what do you think you are doing?
Turned down for what?
Age is a very high price to pay for maturity.
If you love something, set it free. Unless it's a tiger.
Dance until your feet hurt. Sing until your lungs hurt. Act until your William hurt.
Turned down for what?
It's always lonely on the saddle when your horse dies.
One can tell a lot about a person. Life's a garden, right?
Okay. You can't fix stupid. If you want something done right, do it yourself or get your mom to do it.
So we determined that it was a user ID10T error.
To waste your time is to waste your life. Sugar is the devil. Don't die till you're dead. Have love in your heart.
You disgust me. What do you think you're doing?
You can talk to Bruce if you would rather.
The most amazing things can happen to a human being only if they lower their expectations.
You can't roller skate in a buffalo herd, but you can be happy if you've a mind to.
Turn down for what?
Finals are the last 2 days, unless you are exempt.
Well, this is all for our final Falcon Focus.
Alexis, it's been a pleasure working with you.
You too, Springer. So, on behalf of our cast, executive producer Connor Tillo, technology coordinator Dave Rode, and the whole crew, we want to say thank you for a great year.
If you missed the senior slideshow before the ceremony, please stick around for another playing of it after.
Well, I'm Alexis Hawley.
And I'm Springer DeRozier. It's time for us to say goodbye.
Together.
Stay classy, West Burlington.
Thank you, Kaylee, Connor, and the Falcon Focus crew. At this time, I'd like to recognize members of the class of 2014 who are the recipients of various awards and honors. Many of the scholarship winners and award winners are listed on the graduation program insert. I will begin with the recognition of the students who are being honored as members of the West Burlington Arnold High School Silver Cord Society. To qualify for this recognition, students are required to complete a minimum of 400 hours of volunteer service. The symbol of the student's involvement is wearing a silver cord with their graduation robes. The following students have contributed countless hours to the betterment of their church, their school, and their community. At this time, I'd like the following Silver Cord recipients of the class of 2014 to stand and be recognized for this outstanding accomplishment. Please hold your applause until all the list has been called. Jalen Brissy, Ashley Johns, Carissa Todd, Springfield DeRozier, Kenneth Reach, Kaylee Doctorman, and Connor Tillo. Next, I'd like to recognize the recipients of the Academic Excellence Award. This award goes to the students who are ranked in the top 10% of their graduating class. The symbol of the student's achievement is wearing the gold cord with their graduation robes. I'd like these students to stand and remain standing until all students have been called. And again, please hold your applause till the end. Kevin Chang, Keely Switzer, Kaylee Doctorman, Connor Tillo, Dayton Elliott. Now I'd like to recognize the salutatorian for the class of 2014. This student finished their high school career with the second highest grade point average in the class. Would Mr. Connor Tillo please come forward? Next, I'd like to introduce the valedictorian for the class of 2014. The student finished their high school career ranked first in their academic honors. Would Mr. Kevin Chang please come forward? Don't worry, the snipers are watching. The final award is the presentation of the Walter E. Arnold Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded annually to a deserving senior in honor of longtime educator in the West Burlington School District. Mr. Arnold spent his entire career at West Burlington as a classroom teacher and eventually served as superintendent, a position he held at the time of his death in 1971. In honor of his commitment to education, a memorial fund was established, and the interest from that fund provides money for scholarships to the selected graduating seniors. This year's recipient of the Walter E. Arnold Memorial Scholarship is Mr. Kevin Chang. Thank you.
Graduates, it's that time. President Randall, Vice President Sanders, members of the West Burlington Independent School District Board of Education, administration, faculty, staff, parents, and the West Burlington community, I am honored to submit to you the class of 2014. The students have met all West Burlington Board of Education standards and state code requirements, and I recommend them for graduation.
Would the first row of graduates please stand and approach the stage? Akari Arakaki. Jaslyn Cerise Boyd. Austin Paul Boyer. Jalen Nicole Brissy. Sheldon Matthew Brockett. Heidi Elizabeth Brown. Ying Chin. Kevin Chang. Carissa Lee Clark. Springfield M. DeRozier. Randall Marie Diaz. Autumn Dawn Doan. Kaylee Ann Doctorman. Alexis Danielle Detweiler. Dayton Riley Elliott. Raymond Purvis Gallegos. Christy Marie Griffin. Kelsey Rita Hand. Madison Marie Hand. Alexis Marie Hawley. Darian Lee Howard. Jordan Renee Hutchinson. Justin Allen Jennings. Ashley Marie Johns. Brittany Michelle Johnson. Natsumi Kenjo. Would the second row of graduates please stand and approach the stage? Mackenzie Christina Renee Larpender. Austin Jacob Lee. Trevor Michael Lee. Gerard Denzel Lewis. Christine Vanessa McCorker. Michael Devon McGill. Benjamin Joseph Myers. Brandon Michael Paduano. Heidi Marie Prickett. Augusto Salas. Kairos. Christian Ivan Ramos. Kenneth Bernard Reach III. Logan Lee Reich. Darian Christine Ringgold. Robert Michael Robertson. Kyle Paul Rokas. Joel Ryan Salvador. Tanner James Steinbrook. Keely Pauline Switzer. Connor Michael Tillo. Carissa Michelle Todd. Lucas Michael Whitaker. Mackenzie Marie Whitmore. Ethan Bailey Williams. Naoki Yonaha. In closing today's ceremony, on behalf of the staff, the administration, the Board of Education for the West Burlington Independent School District, I'd like to congratulate the class of 2014 and wish you the best for each and every one of you. Family, friends, guests, you're invited to greet the graduates as they are assembled in the receiving lines at the sides of the gymnasium after the processional. Graduates, will you please stand? Turn and face the audience. You may now move your tassel from the left side of your cap to the right, symbolizing your status as high school graduates. Ladies and gentlemen, I proudly present to you the West Burlington Arnold High School graduated class of 2014. Thank you for coming. This concludes our ceremony. Feel free to congratulate the honored students.